request about dynamic slider. In this tutorial, I'm gonna create a dynamic slider where it could be changed according to the admin's desire. So let's get started. As I've designed two types of sliders, both of the sliders counts about three different pictures along with their title, description and subpoints. So both of the sliders have their own different distinct properties. It's the first slider I've used is the slider that has a wall slider style, because it uses the images as the background of any development. As I'm going to show you, I use it for the default page here. Let's look at here. This is the div slide, wall slider style, and in this slider the images it uses are as the property of any div element background. So I remove the div element and place an ASP.NET panel that is server side, so we can add dynamic images to it from the of course database. So I named it img1 and associate a class with it. That was the class of the previous div elements background. So I select it was the first panel, and here there is another ASP.NET panel having the ID of img2. So same class is assigned to it as a CSS class property, and I set a background to it it programmatically. And all of them, both of these panels has a label named LBL image to title, LBL image to description, and we will get the image title from the database and image description from the database and associate it with these labels programmatically. So this was the second image that could be displayed inside the slider, and the first slider also contains LBL image title, LBL image description. Here is another ASP.NET panel having img3 as an ID and having the same background class. So it also contains LBL image 3, LBL image 3 title and description. Of course we can associate as many panels there if the static slider contains any image as a background image. So for associating, I don't associate any picture to these panels. I don't use any data access controls. Here I use ASP.NET SQL data source control to get the messages and displays as a message. So it is not concerned to the slider. Let's move to the programmatic section, and I will show you how I associate the images programmatically. So we code, and let's look at the page load event. I use the page load event here to associate the image title, image description and image source properties programmatically for the all three ASP.NET panels. So let's have a look at here. don't forget to add both of the namespaces here, system.data.sqlclient to connect with SQL Data Server, and system.data to get the collection of data. Now I've declared SQL connection command reader data set data table and adapter here. So I initialize the SQL connection object here, and I'm getting the connection string from the web.config file, and where I've declared the connection and initialize its properties there. Then I use the try case block to handle the exceptions that may be occur during connection, and I'm writing a query to get the image related data to display in the slider, and I'm declaring here a string variable named query equals select top 5 from gallery. Of course you can get as many records, but here for the demonstration purpose I use only the file. Not all of the file, but I'm getting 5 different records and displaying only 3 of them with each 3 sliders. So I'm selecting top 5 from GBL gallery. Yes, I'm getting top 5 because I want to display the latest uploaded or changed data. As I've used auto increment key, primary key type, and TBL gallery, where image category equals sliders, as we have different image categories defined there. So I'm getting the category type of slider that is ordered by image ID. Is ID is auto incremented and is descending order. So the latest uploaded or entered data or image will be on the top, and it will be displayed accordingly. So command equals new SQL command, and I'm passing it a query and a connection that has been initialized. So a connection.open will open your connection, and I'm creating a table object and data set object here, and an adapter equals new SQL data adapter, and I'm passing a command to it. So make sure before passing a command object to it, the connection should be opened. Otherwise, it will prompt you an error and you cannot get the slider working. So, adapter.fill dataset. I'm filling the dataset. Now, the image one, we have to display all of the 3 images as background of the 3 panels that I've declared inside the ASPX file. Is a panel here, image 1, image 2, IMG 2, and IMG 3, and each of these has different labels as a title and description. So first was the image 1 and its background, the image URL property, back image URL equals dataset dot tables 0, as it is a only single table TBL gallery, and it stored the tables the form of arrays. So the array contains the 0th element of array will contain this table record, and I'm going to get its rows. So dot rows, this will be the row 0. Okay, that will be on the top of the records that is newly insert row, as it is on descending order. So row 0 and by column. Let's have a look. What is row 0 and column number 9 in PBL gallery. And I have the database here. So I'm going to show you. There is TBL gallery 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And the image set in the registers property, I've stored the image URL. So let's have a look at it here. Now, this is the image URL. Yes, I have four sliders there. The first slider is hello slider title and full description. Here text says full description. This is index column 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. The ninth column stores the image URL. So let's have just get back to the column, and in the second LBL image title dot text, I'm going to display the text with the title. So data set table 0 same table, same row 0 in column number 2 contains the title. Let's have a look at it. Where title is 0, 1, and 2. There is title. And image dot description dot text table 0, row 0, and column number 4. 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. The description is going to be retrieved and assigned to the LVM description. Similarly, for the second row, we had the image URL, we had the image title, we had the image description, and it will be associated with the slider image 2. Similarly, for the third slider image, we are getting row number 2 as it starts from 0, 1, and 2. Actually, it is the third row, so row 2. We are getting the image URL, image title, and image description. Now, let's have a look how it looks like. It is the third slider, is the second slider, is the first slider here, and we are getting the image, my second slider full description, and a slider full description here. Now let's upload any new slider that I'm going to add another slider here, and this time new slider here, and subject level newer slider and description of the newer slider and description, and it's like your title image category slider category. So submit it and have a look at it. comes, the mirror slider will always be visible at the top, and if I delete any of them, nothing matters. So I'm going to delete the mirror slider, get back to it, and refresh. One of the sliders should be empty. Here it is. So it is updated. It's enough for today. And have a nice day.